Hey guys, we're out here in Shanghai checking out the Vivo Nex 3 5G. And this is a very interesting phone for a lot of reasons, but if we just look at the specs, it's got a Snapdragon 855 Plus, it's got 8 to 12 gigabytes of RAM, it's got 256 gigabytes of UFS 3 storage. It's pretty much truly a 2019 phone. And it's also got 5G in the China region, so that's gonna bump it up a little bit as well. Now there's a lot of stuff to go over in this phone, but one of the most exciting features is probably the 64 megapixel camera. But this camera actually uses a much bigger sensor than we're used to seeing in other phones. So most phones actually use a 1 over 2.5 inch sensor, but this phone is using a 1 over 1.7 inch sensor, which is a lot bigger than most sensors that we see. And you kind of need that for a 64 megapixel camera, because if you just subdivide pixels on a really tiny sensor, you're gonna get less light information in each of those pixel diodes, and it's just gonna come out really crummy. So it's really nice to see that Vivo is using this bigger sensor here. It's actually a Samsung sensor, so we're probably going to see it in a lot of other phones going forward. And of course, you've got that circular camera that we're starting to see in a lot of phones this year. It seems like you either have to make a circular camera or a square camera now to be cool, but you've got a standard lens, an ultra wide lens, and a telephoto lens. So it's really nice if you want to be able to get a shot that's really far away or something that's a lot more up close. Now, Vivo also wanted to push that they've got this super HDR mode specifically for portraits. So it's going to detect faces and the background and try to kind of even that exposure out so that your face isn't blown out or the background not blown out, you're gonna be able to get everything in view. Now, one of the other major features in this phone is that it's using what Vivo is calling a waterfall display. And this basically just means that the screen is going to bleed over the edges of this phone. It's just kind of like a curved display, kind of like we've seen on a lot of Samsung phones, but it's definitely more curved than like the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus or the S10 Plus. Now, interestingly, the screen curves so much that they didn't really have room for like volume rockers or a power button. So they're using capacitive buttons here, kind of like we saw in last year's Vivo phone that came out in December. So you just have these buttons here that you can press down on and it'll kind of vibrate the phone. It uses these capacitive buttons. It's not that weird to use, but I think people will probably get used to it over time. Something else pretty cool about this phone is the really weird pop-up camera in the front. So Vivo has been known to do a lot of different pop-up cameras, but this one's a lot bigger and it also makes this really interesting robotic noise when it lifts out of the phone. It looks pretty cool and it's relatively wide angle. It's not like super wide angle like the Pixel 3, but it gets enough so that you can get both you and your friends in the shot. Something else we've got is 44 watt quick charging, which is kind of interesting that they decided to go exactly 44 watts instead of 45 watts, but we've got 11 volts at 4 amps in this phone, so it shouldn't get too hot while it's pushing all that power into the device. And you kind of need quick charging because, of course, this is a 5G phone. Now, it does not use millimeter wave technology because in China and those regions, millimeter wave isn't that popular yet. Now, Vivo did want to push the fact that they are ready for millimeter wave when that comes out, when that gets a little bit more popular. They're going to be one of the first people to actually push millimeter wave technology. But right now, it is just sub 6 gigahertz. Now, here at our briefing, Vivo was not able to tell me pricing or availability for this device. But here at the event is when they're going to unveil that pricing and availability. So go over to our website and you'll be able to find that over at androidauthority.com for the Vivo Nex 3 5G. So that's been about it for this device. If you want to read more, I've got a whole article over at androidauthority.com. We've got close-up photos with all the angles of this device and pretty much everything you'd want to know about it. So make sure you head over there. And until next time, I'll catch you in the next video. Now, here at the event, Vivo was not able to tell me pricing or availability for this device, but... I'll take it. I'll put that at the end. Okay.